What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Auto.nl. My name is Martin, and today we are in southern Germany visiting our friends from MTM. Now, as you might know, MTM was one of the founding fathers of Auto.nl because they were one of the first that decided to work with us. One of very, very few, because back when we started Auto.nl, everyone was like, you want to do high-speed runs with my car? What about no or no? And MTM were like, yeah, sure, why not? Make a cool video about it. And that's what we're going to do today with their MTM S3 Club Sport. Now, this gen of Audi S3, we really, really like, because it's a very mature and civilized hot hatch, just for not someone in his 20s, maybe 30s or 40s, even 50s, and just enjoy a fast, comfortable daily hot hatch without drawing too much attention from the McDonald's crowd. Actually, MTM have changed the entire car, not just optics-wise and engine-wise, but also the whole spirit of the car is just entirely different. Now, let's start with the wheels. We have these MTM Motorsport wheels, 19-inch with Michelin Pilot Sport 4S tires. Now, that's already a great upgrade. 265 section tires, so pretty wide. And because you have that quattro all-wheel drive system and you want to counteract the understeer, you go for a wider tire on the front axle. And it's also convenient when you unleash all the power with launch control, for example, that you have a lot of rubber on the road. So that 265 tire really helps. We also have MTM brakes, both the caliper and the discs. And what's also cool is that we have the wide body from an Audi RS3, and that's because this car had a little accident and they decided to put the RS3 fenders on here, which actually looks kind of cool. You can really see how wide it actually is over there. We also have a new mirror design with these little thingies on top. It reminds me of the back of the dragon of the MTM logo. Really, really cool. And a nice Club Sport decal right there. We also have a brand new carbon fiber rear spoiler, which does give it a bit of an A45 look from the back, but it does give it a nice and sporty look. MTM badge right there. We have a new quad exhaust system. It's OPF back, because yes, this insane 528 horsepower Audi S3 still has its catalytic converters and the OPF. So that's an amazing accomplishment by MTM. So here we have an MTM roll cage, which just looks awesome. We don't have a back seat anymore, so we also have this special thing to cover up the back seat part. And in the front we have these Recaro podium seats, full carbon fiber seats, ultra thin, ultra lightweight. And you'd think that they are really, really uncomfortable. Just look at how thin this is. It's unbelievable. But they are actually pretty damn comfortable, because you have these thick cushions supporting you at the right spots, keeping you in place and keeping you comfortable. It's actually a great, great seat. And we've also had these seats in the 1000 horsepower RS6 we drove from MTM. But it's a great addition, because with the cornering speeds of this car, the stock seats are a bit underpowered. Let's call it that. Okay, let's have a look under the bonnet. So here we have the EA888 engine. I mean, we've done this engine probably 100 times. So we have a new turbocharger from MTM, as you can see over there. Different downpipe, 200 cell, different exhaust, a bigger intercooler, different intake, and all of that combines to 528 horsepower and 630 newton meters. So stock we have 310 horsepower and 400 newton meters. So this is a big, big step up. And as I said, it's nothing like the stock car. The stock car is just a basis for this, but other than that, they don't have anything in common. Let me show you guys. So we also have a nice Audi S3 Club Sport badge in here, one of 25. It's actually really beautifully made, very flush fit. Little MTM badge right there. And let's start up the 2-liter TFSI engine. So the most impressive thing of this MTM tuning is the fact that you can get warranty. It meets with every requirement when it comes to European road laws. So that's a TÜV license, all EU requirements. This is a road legal tune. If you get checked by the police in any European country, this will be okay. So that's really impressive with this amount of extra power. So revving the engine up, it doesn't sound really all that good, but once you get going, it does actually sound very impressive. And I'm just blown away by the fact that all particle filters and catalytic converters are still in place. That's really impressive. I like the way they did that. Okay, let's turn off traction control completely because we want the car to unleash all that torque and power without the car interfering. Oh, I forgot to tell that we also have a KW suspension set up. And this car is a press car and it has been on track like a week ago. So it's currently on the track setup and it's a mechanically configurable damping. So you have to adjust certain stuff with wrenches. And it's just very, very stiff at the moment. But because of that, really entertaining. So as you can see, we get some nice pops from the exhaust. And the first time you encounter a corner, you can really feel the directness and the aggression of the current chassis setup. It's so nice, especially on roads like this. This is such an entertaining car and so challenging to drive, which really isn't the case with the stock car. So they have really added that. They have really changed that. And that turbo. There is a bit of lag because of the size of the turbo, because down low you just have, let me go to third. You're like, okay, nothing's happening. And then there we go. That is really impressive. So the car actually feels really alive. You're just kept into your seat. You have this amazing suspension setup. It's really communicative, which the stock car just isn't, just not at all. And this is like a little rally car. It honestly feels like that. It does have like the neutral character of a four-wheel drive car. But there is a lot less understeer than you would get with the stock car. The front axle is actually quite eager to steer into a corner. And the vagueness in the center of the steering that the stock car has is just completely gone. And that goes for the entire car. There is a lot of vagueness in the stock car, both in the chassis setup, the steering, the drivetrain. And they've completely eliminated that rubbery feel of everything. It does provide a lot of comfort with the stock car. You know, there's nothing wrong with it. But if you're looking for a challenging car, you don't want that. And they have changed the software for the transmission. So it got a TCU remap. Transmission control unit. Let's turn around here. And you can really feel that. It is still really comfortable, so you don't get like jolts or anything when it upshifts or downshifts. You don't feel the shift. It's just really snappy and aggressive the way you want it to be. Now, another benefit of that bigger turbo is that it just keeps delivering power when the revs go up. With a smaller turbo like the stock turbo, it gets out of breath after like 5,500 RPM. But this one is so eager to rev up. That is so nice. I really, really like that. Okay, let's see what it will do to 100. So stock, we did a 4.7 run with the car with the MTM tune. Whoa, that is 3.5 seconds to 100. That is insane. 3.5 seconds in an Audi A3. Man, the time we live in. Okay, so as you can see, this car is just way too fast, even for these roads, these perfect roads where we can do 100 kph. It's just too fast. And for that, we have the Autobahn. Let's go.
But before we hit the Autobahn, I just want to tell you about today's sponsor, which is Petrol Vibes. We've got the F12 on the wall here. As you can see, we have used it to dress our workshop. It looks absolutely stunning. I love a good silhouette of a car. And you can buy this too at petrolvibes.com. It is made from 2mm thick steel. They laser cut that. You can even have one custom made of your own car if they don't have it in stock already. So go check out petrolvibes.com. They have a lot of cool cars. They've got motorcycles as well. And if you use the code AUTOTOPNL10, you get a 10% discount on your very own Petrol Vibes silhouette. Go check it out and enjoy the video.
So let's give it a try on the German Autobahn. Well, obviously this is not the part where we usually drive, because this is a very, very busy road. As you can see, not exactly ideal for high performance testing, but maybe we're lucky and we pull a gap and we can do a run with this awesome S3. So let's give this side a try. This thing runs, it's pretty damn capable on the Autobahn. It's just one big turbo fest. You can really feel the difference with the stock car, of course. Well, of course you can, because the difference is just absurd, but you're just riding that big turbo and
with the new suspension setup. You get so much feedback through your seat. And these Recaro podium seats do really help with that. You can feel the entire car, each corner, through the seat and the steering wheel. And it's just an incredible sensation. I mean, the stock S3 is no slouch on the Autobahn, but this, really impressive. So I did a high 7.8, 7.9, 100 to 200, which is really impressive. That's AMG E63S territory, and it's even faster than a stock Audi RS6. I mean, that's a 4-liter V8 bi-turbo. An engine twice the size of this. And this just beats it. And I've been doing this for an hour now, and that's when the expertise of MTM comes to life. It just runs like a stock car. It's not too loud. It's quite civilized. And it's just like Audi decided, well, maybe the motorsport department of Audi decided to make an S3 with this amount of power. It's just incredible. Vibrations from these racing brake system, from this brake system from MTM, but the power is really there. So at first you think like, oh, it's not really all that well, but the performance is just really, really good. A lot of stopping power, and it also gives you confidence to really use all those horses and to get up to that top speed of over 300 kilometers an hour, which it will do quite easily. You just need the road to do it. But that was a nice 280 kph run. So today I really, really enjoyed this Audi S3. We applaud the stock car to be like a civilized, matured hot hatch for people who just like a really good fast Audi without being too shouty, you know. And this MTM version is a lot sharper. It's uncomparable to the stock car, but you know, that's mainly because of the suspension and these Recaro seats. You can do this with a stock car, keep the stock suspension set up, and have this lovely, lovely power, and just have a sleeper car. Or if you have an Audi S3 and you've had it for like 2 years now and you think, yeah, I want it to be a little sharper and more entertaining, challenging, which I can really imagine, you don't have to upgrade to an RS3, but go for this with the KW suspension setup. Maybe even go for the crazy seats, because they are really, really good, and you end up with this awesome, awesome little car. So I'm really looking forward to MTM's version of the RS3, which is supposed to be really insane. I mean, I've heard the power levels. Man, that has to be something else. I can really dream of driving that car on our favorite Autobahn. So let's see if we can make that happen. For now, thank you so much for watching. You can subscribe by hitting the big button right here. You can check out this video or go check out this review playlist. Thanks guys, bye.